गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ नारायणी फ्रॉम 9th A Platinum. ओके, सो टूडेज टॉपिक फॉर माई सेमिनार इज सेल. सो वॉट इज बेसिकली द सेल? इज द सेल इज बेसिक स्ट्रक्चरल यूनिट ऑफ अवर लाइफ. देन हु डिस्कवर्ड इट? द सेल वॉज डिस्कवर्ड बाय रॉबर्ट हुक इन 1665. रॉबर्ट हुक इन 1665 टेक अ कॉर्क ऑफ अ बार्क ऑफ अ ट्री एंड ऑब्जर्व अंडर अ प्रिमिटिव माइक्रोस्कोप. He then found something, this structure. He named this structure as a honeycomb-like structure. After some time, he named it as cell. Then from where does this cell word come? The cell is a Latin word named cella. It is a Latin word meaning little rooms. After then, in 1674, Locking Hook, the scientist, observed the free living cells in the pond. After some time, in 1839, the Robert Brown discovered the nucleus in the cell. Then the cell is divided into two parts, that is unicellular and multicellular. Okay, so what does these words mean? Unicellular means, uni means one. The organism having only one cell within it is known as unicellular organism. And the organism having more than one cell, that is many cells, is known as multicellular organism. The example of unicellular organism is amoeba. And the example of multicellular organism is human beings. Then human beings are having some different types of cells, that is animals are also having. This is a smooth muscle cell, then fat cell, then nerve cell, which is a long branch cell, then blood cells, that is spherical in shape, then this is a bone cell, this is ovum and this is sperm. Okay, so now the cell is divided into nucleus and cytoplasm. The plasma membrane is the membrane that separates a cell from one another. The plasma membrane is made up of lipids and proteins. It is having three names, that is cell membrane, plasma membrane and selectively permeable membrane or semi-permeable membrane. The plasma membrane is the one part of a cell. The next part is nucleus. The nucleus is useful in cellular reproduction. That is, it is the central part of a cell. The nucleus is present here in the cell. For example, this is a cell and this is nucleus. The nucleus is in the middle in the body of the animals, but in the body of plants it is in the side. Because of the large vacuole, it is on this side. Then the nucleus is having nucleolus in it, and the nucleus is having chromosomes in it, and the chromosomes carry the genes, that is the hereditary organisms. Then based on the nucleus, the cell is divided into two cells, that is prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Pro means primitive and karyotic means nucleus. That is, prokaryotic. In the prokaryotic cells, the nucleus is not well developed, whereas in eukaryotic, the nucleus is well developed. That is why it is known as prokaryotic, and that is known as eukaryotic. Then, the last part is cytoplasm. The cytoplasm is a jelly-like structure present in the cell. Now, how does cytoplasm works? Actually, it has lots of organelles present in it. That is mitochondria, Golgi bodies, Golgi apparatus, and lysosomes, etc. parts are present in it. Okay, so what is a Golgi body? The Golgi bodies before the Golgi bodies, there is endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum is divided into two parts, that is rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so the endoplasmic reticulum packages the protein into a packets. After that, it gets transported to the Golgi bodies. The Golgi bodies then dispatches it into the other parts of the body. The lysosomes. After that, what is lysosomes? The lysosomes are the secretes enzymes. Okay, so suppose this cell is defective or damaged, the lysosomes then secretes a digestive enzyme into the cell, and the digestive enzyme then digests the cell and bursts itself. Then the cell gets out of the body. Okay, so this is about the lysosomes. The fourth is ribosomes. Ribosomes are present into both prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. Okay, this is all about the cells. And one part is that ribosomes are present on the rough endoplasmic reticulum, that